Hey guys, what's up? It's I Can Fly Jake, and today we're back here. It's that time again for the status report, and by that time again, it actually is a little bit late here. I know status report came out on Tuesday, and you're probably watching this. Definitely not on Tuesday. I'm already recording it quite a bit late, but I've had some exams this week and exams last week, so it's just been kind of tough, and I've been quite busy with school, so I do apologize, but I'm here now to make a video on the status report, and it's a pretty juicy one. I enjoyed it quite a bit, and it's really getting me hyped for the future, which isn't always a good thing with DayZ, because hype for the future often ends in disappointment, and I'm hoping this one doesn't, so let's get right into it. So basically, last week or the week before, the server files were released, and I will have a video coming out in a few days or a week talking about server files and how, you know, just some stuff with it and how it's really cool and what it can do for you. So make sure to subscribe and check that out. Anyway, so the server files are out. And if you guys don't know what those are, quick overview, basically, it's just a bunch of customization for the server owners to do. And it's like the first initial sort of modding feel we can get, but modding still isn't out, although we can expect it moderately soon. So now that that is out, they said the server files, they've said that the next patch that they're going to be pushing towards the stress tests branch will be considered an experimental beta, and it will contain new content and features, including vehicles and base building. They said, we will offer a detailed list of the beta package later on, and the list for both features and content is not exactly short, so they have to make sure everything works. So I totally understand this if they're actually ready to be releasing some sort of experimental beta, like, not even some sort, the experimental beta. Take your time, I guess. I mean, they've only got till the end of the year to get this game out in 1.0. So at this point, I'm not even harping on them for when they get these exact, you know, technical names out, like beta and go into 1.0, because the 1.0 release is end of the year. So whatever they can get done between now and then is going to be, it's going to impress me if they get a lot done, because that's a short amount of time, and they must be hiding some tricks up their sleeves for what they have done, and I think we're going to get a taste of that come beta, because, you know, we've been held back for quite a few months here by some sort of server issues, and just issues between the server and the clients, and they've seemed to have fixed them, and they've said that just because of these serious delays, the work on the internal version of the game has not stopped, and so that means one thing, that the next patch arriving to stress test branch will be the experimental beta. So that's really good news, and that's the sort of tricks I'm hoping they're, you know, hiding up their sleeve, is these features and content they've been working on internally during these past months. So I'm really hoping this beta brings in quite a few new items, some vehicles that work really, really well, because the problem with DayZ is a lot of times you feel like you don't have a big goal in the game, and vehicles, the ones that will be coming pretty soon, give you a goal. You know, you come to a new town, it's like, hey, I don't want to just sprint straight to this town. Let's see if we find a vehicle. Oh, shoot, this small town that normally I run right through, I found some food in, and oh, here's a broken down Jeep over here, or a broken down off-road car. Let's look around this town and see if we can find some parts for it. Oh, shoot, a bunch of zombies around me. Oh, shoot, here's another guy also looking for parts for the car. It creates interaction, and then once you get that car made, you're zipping around Chernarus really, really quickly. Also, with this whole modding thing coming soon, we'll be getting some custom maps. You're zipping around other things that aren't Chernarus. More on that even in that video I was talking about, so again, subscribe and check that out whenever that comes out. Here we have some pretty cool animations regarding the vehicles, and also some physics showing how the collisions work, and they look really, really good. That's one thing I remember back from the other DayZ, is that vehicles, like, while they worked decently, the animations were crappy, the suspensions in them, and the sliding around the map, and the glitchiness with them, they were just so glitchy, and they broke so easily, and they didn't feel like real vehicles, or even fun at all. And one thing that was the worst about it was any sort of collisions. You drive over a fence post and you're stuck in the fence permanently, your car blows up or it's stuck there, and in fact maybe it doesn't blow up and instead you never get to find that car again because it's stuck on there until the server restarts. On top of that, collisions with other vehicles never worked well. You guys go straight through each other, you get stuck inside each other's cars. Seems to be a big issue because I remember seeing this in the PUBG game as well. So hopefully DayZ has done something about this. And as you can see in these animations, the collisions look really, really good. I'm not seeing any sort of glitchiness with it. I'm sure, you know, as we get these vehicles before 1.0, there are going to be some glitches with them, as vehicles have tons of complicated systems regarding on specific parts to keep them running and specific parts that can break. You know, including the doors on the vehicle, that I'm assuming if the door is gone, objects can go through the door, such as, you know, melee weapons or bullets or punching or whatever it is. And if the door is there, it's a physical object. So there's just a lot of things going on at the vehicles, and it seems like they've put a lot of work into them, and I'm hoping we get to feel that. These GIFs here I'm showing you on screen make it look pretty dang good. I'm actually watching them live with you guys now. Or not with you, I guess, but, you know, live as I'm talking about it. Anyways, and they also say that they had to rework the input system with the cars due to the requirements to simply add new actions. And they're saying this is something that the modders will appreciate. So, interestingly enough, that comment seems to hint that the modders will have a lot of control over the vehicles, which I'm really interested to see what that does. There's some really cool graphics regarding speed you can see in the GIFs there as well, in the bottom left of the screen. But yeah, I'd like to see some custom vehicles. My curiosity is if we're going to get some sort of bike in the game before the developers actually release it. Because you guys didn't know, bikes aren't going to be coming anytime soon. That's a future. They want those to work well and look good. And I'm thinking that modders are honestly going to implement bikes on their own. And just they won't look really good, but they'll work. And I think that's how it's going to be. I bet they work similar to how they did in Arma 2. Here we see some work done by the animators and motion capture people. They got some new animations. It looks pretty funny, them in all these suits here. Apparently somebody's sleeping or laying on a pillow. I don't know if that was for audio or just for the picture or the motion capture. I'm sure it was obviously for the motion capture. But figured I would show you guys that. Also, if you guys have ever used any sort of light source in the game, you've probably thought they don't work very well. Like, sure, if you hold down the button constantly and aim it exactly where you want to look, it does light it up and it looks graphically okay. But they're not useful. It's never, ever, ever, in my opinion, been functional to use a flashlight or even a tactical flashlight on a gun, except to maybe blind your enemy as you aim your gun at them. But they said that there's actually many new things and improvements they've done on the animation graph side, and one of them, just to speak, is the aiming of the flashlight, torches, and other items. So I know this is such a small thing, but as you can see in these animations, they actually look pretty useful, and it lights up a much greater area. Looks really good, as you can see, like the light is focused in the center there. And I'm really hoping that you don't have to like normally when you hold the flashlight, you have to hold down the right click button often just to hold it in the right spot. And like that's just not fun. You don't want to run around with your flashlight swinging around all over your screen, spraying light everywhere, telling everybody in Chernarus, "Hey, I'm here, shoot me." And I know you don't. All of you have your gamma turned up and don't need flashlights, but I'm playing the game legitimately, and I'm telling you exactly where I'm at. So basically, hopefully these things are a bit more useful, or actually way more useful. And they say that the light beam now aims where you are looking, no matter if the character is standing or moving, and that the flashlight should be your best friend from now on in dark areas. And they've also added a small detail in the form of an animation for switching the flashlight on and off. You can guys see that there on the GIF, his thumb kind of clicks it. Very cool little touch, but mainly the big thing here is the accuracy of the lighting, which is freaking awesome. Lastly here, guys, there's a quick update from Philip, the audio engineering lead guy, or just the guy that writes about it, I guess. He says that, you know, the entire audio team is continuing to work on the overall audio appeal of DayZ, and they've created a range of new updated game sounds. I'm going to list them off for you guys. They're actually kind of interesting. Just for especially you guys that haven't heard the game in a while, the game actually has some incredibly accurate audio and in-depth audio, such as if there's like a wall between you and the guy that shot a gun, the sound will, you know, it'll be dampened by the wall, but you can still hear it around the corner. Like, there's some really accurate audio. There's bugs and birds inside of trees, like as you walk by, and it'll sound like it's behind you and moves past you as you walk by it. Just some really cool sounds. So I'm going to read these off. There's some very specific sounds. I thought it was somewhat interesting. There's new rain sounds for tarmac tile and wooden roof surfaces. They updated the rain sounds for trees and bushes, the leaf rustling sounds, the empty vessel and pour liquid sounds, even the sounds for pouring water from one vessel into another, the sounds for jumping and landing, sounds for various items to pick up, new sounds for carrying weapons on your shoulder. The infected, they play different footsteps depending what they're wearing, which is really cool. So if they're wearing sneakers, they make one sound. If they're wearing boots, they make, you know, a boot sound. I'm hoping this isn't like the squeak squeak from SpongeBob. If you guys get that reference, let me know in the comment section down below, the squeaky boots. Bare feet sound different. And then new sounds for eating fruit, cereal, and taking pills. So apparently we're about to be popping some pills in DayZ. But don't pop too many. You don't want to die. Maybe you pop just the right amount to cure that illness, because if you guys didn't know, this game is full of them. You can get ill, and pills may solve that ill. I can make a rhyme any moment. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Looks like we're sitting at about 9 minutes 20 seconds, not passing that cringy 10-minute mark. That's all right. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like I said, make sure to drop a like if you liked it. Those likes always help out. And subscribe for more DayZ content. And I really hope to see all of you guys watching this video in my next video or live stream. Come hang out. Thanks for watching.